In chapter 7, we're going to talk about confidence intervals. So in 7.2, we're going to talk about confidence intervals for proportions. And then later in the chapter, we'll talk about doing the same thing for averages or means. So we can start off by asking a question like this. What percent of adults in the U.S. are in favor of the death penalty? And we want to come up with some range that we think is reasonable. So we did a survey, and a random survey of 500 adults was taken, and 55% of them were in favor of the death penalty. Now, we know since this was a survey, it's unlikely that exactly 55% of all adults in the U.S. are in favor of the death penalty. But this is called our sample proportion. We call this p-hat. So p-hat will always mean the sample proportion, the percent you get from the sample. And we call this the point estimate. So we want to know, based on this survey, what can we conclude about the entire adult U.S. population? What's the actual proportion, which we always just call p? So a couple things we know. We know that a sample proportion is an unbiased indicator for the population's proportion, meaning that if it's a truly random sample, then it will give us an indicator, so an estimate. So our answer should be based on the point estimate. So we could say something like this. Based on our survey, we are pretty sure that something close to 55% of the adult U.S. population is in favor of the death penalty. Now, there might be a couple things that you're kind of, you know, thinking, wow, that doesn't sound mathematical. For example, one of the things says, you know, why are we just saying we're pretty sure? How sure are we? Now, with only a sample, we can never be 100% sure. To be 100% sure of what adult, you know, how many people in the adult in the U.S. are in favor of the death penalty, we'd have to ask every single person. Okay, we'd have to take a census, but that's not very practical. So here, if we took all samples of size 500, doing sample distributions like we talked about in chapter 6, we'd have a normal distribution, and it would peak at our point estimate of 55%. Now, how sure we want to be is called a confidence interval, a confidence level. And there are three common levels, 90%, 95%, and 99%. And obviously, you always want to be as sure as you can, but sometimes we'll see that you have to take a larger sample, or it may be less practical. Now, if we're 90% confident, that means we have a 10% error. If we're 95% confident, obviously we have a 5% error. And if we're 99% confident, we have a 1% error. Okay, so those error values are called our alpha values. So when we're doing a problem, or you'll be given in the problem, how confident we want to be. Okay, so a 95% confidence level, if that's one we chose, would mean if we took 100 similar surveys about the death penalty, 95 of those surveys would have a proportion that's somewhat close to the actual proportion. So it would get very close. So now if we've chosen our confidence level, like 95%, we could say something like, we are 95% confident that something close to 55% of all the adult U.S. population is in favor of the death penalty. Or we could say something like, we don't know what the actual percent is, but we're 95% sure that it's something close to 55. Now you might be saying something close, that doesn't sound mathematical at all. And that's what we'll have to figure out. So for example, we might have an interval that says we are 95% confident that between 50% and 60% of the adult U.S. population is in favor of the death penalty. But now we have to figure out, why did we just have 50 to 60%? What will that interval actually be? So how big our interval will actually be depends on how confident we want to be in our answer. Okay, the more confident we want to be, the larger we have to make our interval. Okay, so with just a sample, if we wanted to be 100% right, we'd have to say between 0% and 100%, somewhere between 0% and 100% of people are in favor of the death penalty. And that really tells you nothing. We knew that. To be 95% to be right 95% of the time, or have a 95% confidence level, we'd have to make an interval big enough to include 95% of all possible values in the middle of the distribution. And the same thing for 99% or 90%. So however confident we want to be, we have to find an interval big enough to include that percent in the middle of the distribution. Okay, so from the empirical rule that we learned back several chapters ago, we already know that to get 95% of all possible values in the normal distribution, we have to go about two standard deviations. Now, that's always rounding. The actual number of standard deviations is 1.96. Okay, we'll be using these numbers. Now, these numbers of how far we have to go out, how many standard deviations, are called our Z alpha over 2 values. Okay, and these values, they're on the Z chart in the bottom right-hand corner, so you don't have to necessarily memorize them. For a 95% confidence level, our Z alpha over 2 value is 1.96. And you'll see the Z alpha over 2 come up in a formula, and so that's where you'll plug in these numbers, depending on which confidence level you've chosen. For a 90% confidence level, our Z alpha over 2 is 1.645. And for a 99% confidence level, our Z alpha over 2 value is 2.575. Okay, now we know that the standard deviation for a binomial distribution, we take the square root of NPQ. However, this is a little different. This is the distribution of sample proportions, and here the standard deviation is equal to the square root of p hat q hat over n. Now p hat is our sample proportion, q hat is its complement, so q hat is equal to 1 minus p hat, and n, as always, is the sample size. So to get what's called our margin of error, how far we're going to go out from our middle point, this is called E. And to find E, we use Z alpha over 2 for whatever confidence level. So this is going to depend on your confidence level. Okay, and then we'll plug in P hat, Q hat over N. So this isn't a difficult formula. So for our example, to be 95% confidence, our Z alpha over 2 for 95% is 1.96. Then we're going to take the square root, our P hat, our sample. Original sample is 0.55, so Q hat is going to be 1 minus 0.55, or 0.45, and then our sample size was 500. Okay, so if you put this in your calculator, you would get 0.044, which is the same as 4.4%. So to get our actual interval, we're going to have p hat minus e, and then we'll go up to p hat plus e. So this would be 55% minus 4.4% up to 55% plus 4.4%. Okay, so we can say we are 95% confident that between, now if we do 55 minus 4.4, we get 50.6, so that's our lower value percent. And if we do 55 plus 4.4, that gives us 59.4%. So we can say we are 95% confident that between 50.6% and 59.4% of the adult U.S. population is in favor of the death penalty. Now, we can always say these statements two ways. And the other way we can say it is that we are 95% confident that 55, we can start with our sample point estimate, 55% of the adult U.S. population are in favor of the death penalty with a margin of error of 4.4%. So we can put our E value there. Okay, so moving on to a different example. It says, in a recent Gallup poll, 1,025 randomly selected adults were surveyed, and 29% of them said that they had used the internet for shopping at least a few times each year. So we want to create a confidence interval of what percent of adults do we think use the internet? Okay. So we want to use, it tells us to use a 90% confidence level. Okay. So with a 90% confidence level, our error is 10%. And we know the Z alpha over 2 value for 90 is 1.645. So we'd be plugging that in for Z alpha over 2. Now our point estimate is the percentage of adults who said they did use shopping. So that was 29% or 0.29. Our Q hat, then we're going to do 1 minus 0.29, which is 0.71. And the sample size we're given is 1025. So now remember our formula, Z alpha over 2 times the square root of P hat Q hat over N. So we're going to take 1.645 times the square root of 0.29 times 0.71 over 1025. Okay, and if we put that into our calculator, we get 0.023 or 2.3%. So our interval, we always use that point estimate as a starting point. We're going to go 29% minus 2.3% and 29% plus 2.3%. So our interval goes from 26.7% up to 31.3%. So our final statement is that we can say we are 90% confident that between 26.7% and 31.3% of all adults use the internet, for shopping at least a few times a year. Okay, now, sometimes what we actually want to do is we want to find the sample size that's required to get a certain margin of error. So maybe we only want 2% around our interval. And we want to know how many people we have to sample so that our interval is only 2% on either side or something like that. Now, there's two different formulas we use. One, if we know p hat, if we know the sample size, the point estimate, and one if we don't. Now, knowing the point estimate is not very likely, but sometimes we might. We might have a guess or something. So if you know p hat, the sample size is equal to, you'll also have a given confidence interval, confidence level. So it's equal to the Z alpha over 2 value squared times P hat Q hat over E squared. Now, if we don't know P hat, we actually assume that P hat and Q hat are both 0.5. So if we plug 0.5 in here for P hat and Q hat, that would give us 0.25. So if we don't know the actual point estimate, or have a guess for it, we'd use Z alpha over 2 squared times 0.25 over E squared. Now, one thing to remember is if we tell you you have to sample at least 10.5 people, well, you can't sample 0.5 of a person. So you always have to round up to the next whole person. So we always round up to the next whole person. Okay, because you can't sample just part of a person. Okay, so if we want to do an example of this, our problem says Toyota provides an option of a sunroof and a side airbag package for $1,400 for its Corolla model. Toyota wants to determine the percent of Corolla buyers who would pay an additional $1,400 for this package. Okay, so we want to know what is the minimum number of buyers that need to be surveyed for us to get a 95% confidence interval that has a margin of error of plus or minus 3 percentage points. Okay, now we don't know the percent of people who would do this, so we don't know p hat here. So we're going to use the formula n equals z alpha over 2 squared times 0.25 over our e squared. And we'll use that as a decimal. Okay, so our z alpha over 2 here, since we're going to use a 95% confidence level, is 1.96. And the margin of error as a decimal is 0.03. So we're going to plug these numbers in and we get n equals 1.96 squared times 0.25 over 0.03 squared. And if you plug this into your calculator, this gives you 1067.1. Now this is the minimum number we'd have to sample. And we can't sample a tenth of a person. So we round up to 1068. So we need to sample 1,068 people to get a sufficient sample size.